Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastytubes.com. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to create individual vector shapes using the shape tool. In this video, we are going to be using some of those shapes and learn how to create groups and learn how we can take those groups and compound multiple vectors into new individual vector shapes. Now, the best way to learn is by watching and doing. So to help you, I have created this worksheet. To follow along with this tutorial, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This can be found in the Essential Practice folder, in the project folder. Now, you can download this project folder for free. The link is in the description. Along the way, I will be mentioning some useful shortcut keys, which you can find in the description and in the shortcut key page in the project PDF, which you can also download in the description. So with the project folder open, click Essential Practice, Grouped Vectors, Versions, and select the version of Illustrator you're using. In my case, it's CC, and open the grouped vector file, and you should have something that looks like this. Now, we are going to be covering a lot in this video and in quite some depth. If you wish to skip ahead at any point in the video or back, you can simply look in the description, and all the topics covered in this video are listed along with their times. So be sure to check that out. Okay, so once you have this document open, let's get into it. So here on the left, we have our shapes from the previous tutorial, and on the right, we have our worksheet, which we are going to work to. So let's zoom in to the top of the second artboard to begin. First, we need to create a little composition using some of the shapes from the first artboard. So by pressing and holding spacebar, I can click and move over like so. First, I need the diamond shape vector. So I'm going to press V to activate the selection tool, and then I'm going to select it. Then I'm going to press and hold Alt on the keyboard and click and drag it over. And this is going to quickly duplicate the shape. Next, I need the square. So I'm going to select the square vector, press and hold Alt on the keyboard and drag it over onto my worksheet. Next, I need the triangle on the side. So I'm going to select and duplicate this vector as well. And finally, I need the circle shape, so I will select and duplicate this and drag it over to my composition. So let's zoom into our new composition and quickly move them into position to reflect the worksheet. Now, as you can see, some of the vectors are sitting on top of each other. In Illustrator, like in Photoshop, we can use layers. And if we come to the right to see our work panels and click on the layers panel, we can see we are currently working on the work area layer. If you can't see this panel, you can come to Window, scroll down, and click the Layers panel here. Now, in Illustrator, we can create multiple vectors on one layer, and it works in a hierarchy structure. So the first vector you create on a layer is simply at the bottom of the pile. Then the next vector created will be on top of that, and the next vector created will be on top of that, and so on and so on. Now, you can control this structure and arrange your vectors. For example, let's bring the bottom vector to the top. To do this, you can click the bottom vector, right-click, and this will bring up a menu list. Then scroll down to Arrange and select Bring to Front. And now that vector is on the top, like so. Now, if we want to select this circle here and push it to the back, we can do that by again right-clicking, scrolling down to Arrange, and clicking Center Back. Easy. Now, as this title here suggests, these are ungrouped vectors. Now, what does this mean? Well, this means I can select each vector shape individually like so, and there is no current connection between them. However, if I click and drag using the selection tool over all the shapes like so and release, I will make a selection and now they are all selected. Now, we can see a bounding box around all of the shapes. With these individual vectors selected, we can actually make changes to them all in one go. For example, with them all selected, I can change the color of the fill by clicking on the fill in the menu, selecting a color, and also clicking on the stroke color and changing that. I will just click off to deselect the shapes. So clicking and dragging with your selection tool over individual vector shapes can allow you to change multiple vector colors and effects in one instance. By holding Shift on the keyboard, I can select one shape, then another, and this will select multiple shapes individually. where perhaps I can make a change to particular shapes. So again, I'm going to click off to deselect, and this time click and drag to select them all. This will now allow us, with the selection tool, to click and move the selection around. We can rotate, and we can change the size. But we don't want to do that right now, so I will undo this. So now I have all the individual vectors selected, I'm going to press and hold Alt on the keyboard and click and drag over to the right, and I will quickly duplicate the vectors like so. So now we have two compositions. So with all of these vectors selected, I'm going to come to the menu at the bottom and click the default fill and stroke button to reset these colors back to black and white. This time, with the vector selected, I'm going to come to Object and select Group, or I could press Command G on the keyboard. Now, once I have done this, I'm going to click off the shapes to deselect. Now, if I move my mouse cursor over any of these shapes and click, we will select all of them. That is because these vector shapes are now grouped together. So all our vector shapes to the left are individuals, and this composition to the right is grouped. This helps if you're creating a complex piece of artwork and moving vectors around a lot. You can group all objects together in this way, such as text objects, vector shapes, and images. So now these vectors are grouped. All we have to do is select just once, and we will select them all. And we can add effects, like a color fill, and edit the stroke very easily. Now, it's important to note that even though these vectors are now grouped, we can still edit the vector shapes as individuals. For example, if I click on the group, we will select the group. Though if I double-click on one of the shapes in the group, we will click into that group, and I can isolate that part and click and move that part of the group around, or even add new effects. Notice how all other objects on the canvas area turn opaque, and we have this grey bar at the top showing us which level we are at within the group. Once I'm happy with my modification, I'm simply going to double-click into the white canvas shape, and with the selection tool, if I select the vector, we can see it's still part of a group. So I'm going to double-click back onto the vector shape and put the shape back into its previous position. Now, sometimes you may wish to ungroup a group of vectors. If you want to separate them, to do this is quite simple. With your group selected, come to Object and select Ungroup. Upon click, you will break the group up, and now they are treated as individual elements. But I want to keep this group, so I'm going to select all of them and come back to Object and click Group. Excellent. Okay, so that's how to create and manage a vector group. Next, I'm going to click on my vector group, press and hold Alt on the keyboard, and drag the group to duplicate it down, like so, under the title Compound Shape. And just like earlier, I'm going to click on the default color and stroke to reset the vector colors. So, as it currently stands, this group contains four individual vector shapes. Now, we are going to compound these shapes together to create a single vector shape. To do this, we are going to use the Pathfinder tool. Now, I have mine to hand over to the right at the bottom of my screen. If you cannot see this panel, simply come up to Window, scroll down and select Pathfinder. If we look in the Pathfinder panel, we can see various shape modes and pathfinders. What we are about to do is merge the four vectors that create up this group into a single shape. So with the group selected, I'm going to come over to the Pathfinder tool and click the first icon to the left called Unite. And upon click, you can now see that these shapes have become one. If we look closely, we can see the anchor points and the vector outline that now makes up this new shape. So now we have this new shape, we can alter the effects on this as one, such as the stroke. We can push this up and turn the fill to transparent. It's important to mention that once you compound the vectors like this, you can no longer access the previous shapes as individuals, so be careful when using this technique. So I'm going to select the shape with my selection tool and press and hold Alt and drag it over to the right to duplicate the shape like so. This time, I'm going to make the stroke transparent, click on the fill color, come to the swatches panel and select a gradient. So sometimes you may need to create compound shapes in order to apply various effects. If I click on my top group and apply the same gradient, we can see it's not the same as with the compound shape below. Here we get a nice gradient across the entire shape. So next we are going to look at the Shape Builder tool. Now the Shape Builder tool works similar to the Pathfinder tool. With the Shape Builder tool, you can merge, cut and slice shapes with more control to create more interesting outcomes. So first we're going to come up and select our ungrouped vectors. With the selection tool, I'm going to click and drag an area to select them all, click and hold Alt on the keyboard and drag them down under my Shape Builder tool header. Next, I'm going to come over to the menu and select the Shape Builder tool, which is just under the Free Transform tool. Now, with the Shape Builder tool activated, I'm going to come over to the group vectors and move the mouse cursor over the shapes. So, this selection of vectors contains four individual vector shapes, and they are overlapping each other. As we move the mouse cursor over the selected vectors with the Shape Builder tool, Illustrator will highlight all the various shapes within the group. We can see the areas that overlap and the areas that do not. So let's say we want to merge just the diamond shape with the triangle below. With the Shape Builder tool, you can click and drag over the two shapes, and you can see they now become compounded. Let's say we want to cut out the top part of the circle as they overlap here. Well, with the Shape Builder tool, we can click on that area, and it will cut it away. With the Selection tool, I can now click that shape and move it to the side. So here, we have not only cut that shape away, but created a new shape here too. So now I have a bunch of new vector shapes. I can move them around and space them out like so, and change them individually. Pretty cool. So next, I'm going to select my compound shape I created earlier, and press and hold Alt to click and drag to duplicate it below, and click on the default Color Fill button. This time, we are going to come to our first artboard, and holding Shift, select the circle, the star, and the polygon shape. I will press and hold Alt and drag them across to duplicate them. And with them all selected, I'm going to scale them down like so, holding Shift, and change the color fill to black. Then, I'm going to select each shape and move them over to my vector shape, like so. But notice how they are behind the larger shape. So now I'm going to click on the big shape, right-click, scroll down to Arrange and send to Back, and now we can see our new black shapes on top. I'm quickly going to scale up my star, like so. So now we have our vector with smaller overlapping shape vectors. Next, I'm going to make a selection over this new composition with my selection tool. I'm going to click and drag over them. Now, I could group these if I want to, as demonstrated earlier, but I have a different plan for this. With the vector selected, I'm going to press and hold Alt on the keyboard and click and drag across and down like so to make a quick duplication. Now we are going to do something a little different. What we are about to do is cut the black vector shapes out of the larger vector below to make a new shape. So with them all selected, we are going to come again to the Pathfinder panel, and this time we are going to come to the fourth icon across and click on the Exclude button. Upon click, you will now see that the individual vectors become compounded into one vector. If I remove the stroke and apply the same gradient as before, we can see we have the transparent shapes in our vector. Now, if we want to modify these holes in our shape, we will need to use the direct selection tool. For example, let's zoom right into this shape. I will press A on the keyboard to activate the direct selection tool and then click on the shape. Now we can see the red anchor points that make up the shape. Now it's a case of simply selecting one of the anchor points and moving it around. Though if I want to move the entire hole around, I will first need to select the anchor point, then hold Shift and select the rest of the anchor points to move them around using the arrow keys. Simple. So zooming out with the selection tool, I'm going to click and duplicate the shape across, pressing Alt as I drag, and simply swap the fill and stroke color, and push up the stroke. And we can see how the gradient also applies to our stroke on the new compound shape. So that is how we can arrange our vectors, group our vectors, compound individual vectors into single vectors, and cut shapes out of vectors. It all comes down to what artistic effect you are trying to achieve in your artwork, and to what extent you wish to organize your vectors. Grouping vectors can simply help with your workflow, though compounding vectors can help achieve a particular aesthetic for your artwork. In the next video, we are going to learn how to draw in Illustrator and learn how to effectively use the pen tool, the brush tool, and the pencil tool. See you in the next video.